figure skater. I watched a movie called Ice Princess, and it's about figure skating. And as soon as I watched it, I fell in love with the sport, and I decided immediately that I want to try the sport out. And the more I went to the rink to skate, the more I loved it, and I decided to do it professionally eventually. I faced so many obstacles. Well, at the beginning, it was my dad trying to convince him to allow me to skate once I reached like 15 years old or 16. He was like, okay, just do it as a hobby. Like, he didn't want it to become serious. But then after a while, he realized that I really love the sport, and he realized that there's nothing wrong with it. So he then allowed me to compete, and he's supporting me 100%. And then after that, once I started competing internationally, it was a challenge to get the judges to not give me deductions because of the hijab, because it's the first time someone covered competes in this sport. And they saw me and they realized there's nothing wrong with it, so now they allow covered girls to participate in the sport without getting deductions. And then the last thing is the people's opinions around me, especially in the Arab world. They're not familiar with figure skating, and they just said, oh, it's just dancing, it's not a sport. I had to prove to them that it's actual sport, and there's nothing wrong with it. And once they learned more about this sport, now people are accepting it, and they're so supportive, not only in the UAE, also like worldwide. Everyone is very supportive, and everyone wants to see me in the Olympics. My training schedule is 4 hours a day, but I work really early in the morning. And so I wake up at like 5 a.m. and I go straight to training, and I finish around 2:00. So that way, at least I have the rest of the day to do something for myself. When it comes to diet, skaters have a really strict diet, because in skating, first of all, if you grow even an inch higher or even gain 0.5 kg, your whole jumps are gone. They can be from one day they're perfect, the next day that's it, they're gone, because our body weight has to do a big thing in skating because of the height that we get. So we have to try our best to maintain our weight. It's perfect if you're losing the weight, because then your jumps are lighter, but you can never even gain like 0.3 kilos at all, zero. So we try to eat very low carbs, because we need the energy, but at the same time, carbs will make us gain weight. And like, before training, we're allowed to have carbs, but then once we finish training for the day, you're not allowed to have carbs. And you just have to eat very healthy, and obviously no sweets, no chocolate. And chocolate is my favorite thing, so it's hard. But I always tell myself, once I stop skating, I can eat whatever I want. So for now, it's okay. You're going to have good days, you're going to have bad days. I mean, you're human, we all have bad days, but the most important thing to remember is those bad days are what will make you stronger. You fall 8 times, it doesn't matter, you get up and you keep trying, because if you give up, that's it. There was no point for you throughout the whole journey to just suddenly give up. You never know, you fall 8 times, then maybe that 9th time you'll actually land that jump. So just never give up, always follow your heart and follow your dreams, and just work hard.